going on, guys? It's CT with CT's Touch Horses, /dog. So y'all know I brought Graham back. Went back to doing some groundwork with him. He's just as flighty and snorty, but he has retained some of the stuff that I left him with when I turned him out. I'm going to get on Graham's back today. I had my buddy get on him the other day. He did okay. We didn't do much with him, just kind of got on him, let him walk around, you know, felt him out a little bit. He's a little flighty, jumpy, leery of everything. I hadn't done anything with him today, well, this evening. I worked him this morning. I did some groundwork, some round pin work with him this morning, but I'm gonna bridle him here and let you guys see him move around a little bit. So I'm gonna go ahead and take the halter off and beat him up. Yeah. See, he wants to try to fight it a little bit. But it's none of that. So I'm gonna move him around a little bit. Got a big hump in his back. So Graham got a big old hump in his back, guys. All I'm doing right now is just letting him walk off in a circle, teaching him what the bit is about, get to that bit. Buddy got these stirrups up a little too high for me. Right now, Graham is just playing with the bit too much. He's got his mind on the bit. You look at his ears, one going one way, one going the other way. So this is pretty much all I do when I first get on one. I don't ask him to do much, but just kind of walk in a circle. Then I ask him to yield his hindquarters right there. So he wants to stop on his own like that. I'll make him move right back out. So I did touch him with them spurs a minute ago. He felt them. You seen him jump out? Make him yield his hindquarters. See, he's starting to figure out what I want when I ask him to put his head down. So if you notice, guys, I don't have no tie down or no training aid to help me keep his head down. I'm just teaching him to give to the bit. Those ears tell me that he's not comfortable with me up here yet. Putting some pressure on him, asking him to give to that bit. He's bracing into it for a moment. But when he gives to it, I'll let him know he did okay. I'm driving him with both feet right now. He's still bracing on that bit. There you go. He gave to it a little bit. Right here, I'm just going to get him to take a step back. And I'm going to take the pressure off, but I want him to take his head down. I want him to get that head out there. You ain't quite got that head out there yet. There you go. There he goes. Come right back to walking him in a circle. Get ground to give to this bit a little bit. Want to cut that circle off right there. Y'all see all that head bobbing and stuff he's doing? There he goes, he's starting to relax a little bit. Notice that head is starting to relax. I'm gonna stop him right here. He's starting to give to the bit a little bit. So I can tell ground's mouth's a little hard. But I'll fix it. Notice where my hands is, guys. Notice where my hands. They're up here above my saddle horn where I would ride my horse. I'm not working him down here. I'm not working him down here. I'm working him up top. Make him walk out. The only thing I'm teaching Graham right here is to move out and give to the bit. See, now he's starting to give to the bit. Starting to give to the bit now. Your little head's coming down, guys. Y'all see that head start coming down on the way around? Want him to give his chin. So I'm trying to get Graham to back up, but I want him to give his chin to me. He's wanting to brace on the bit. I'm not going to release him right there. Get his chin down. Go right back to back. See how he wants to try to take his head from me? Brown wants to try to take his head from me. He's out here grunting and shit. There you go. There you go. Giving that head, giving that face. There you go. You giving to that bit a little bit now. Got that head down. There you go. Now he's starting to relax and get his head down and pay attention. Starting to give to the bit. Giving to the bit, guys. There he goes. See if he gives to it on the back. He's wanting to get his chin in. There you go. Get it in. Get it in. Get it in. Tried to bite me that time, because I'm touching him in his flank. Look where that head is. I want that head to get down. Mm-hmm. back to not paying attention. Start it softening up a little bit. Thank you. Right there, he should be getting off of that bit. Not with his nose up in there. All right, guys, so Rome wasn't built in a day. Graham is stiff as all outdoors. He's stiff as about a 12-year-old boy back in the late 70s, man. He's chomping on this bit. He's bracing into it. But I want y'all to notice what his head was doing when I first started versus what his head was doing when I come around the video toward the end. So it's my job to soften his mouth up, teach him what this bit is about. And in this session right here, that's all I was working on. I wasn't working on no leg pressure, no leg cues. I wasn't working on nothing. Just teaching him to respect this bit. And until I got that, there's no use of me trying to do anything else. But I always disengage their hindquarters. And when I say disengage, I always reach back there. If I touch them on the left, I want them to move away from it. Because if I get my horses to learn that in the beginning, that's going to keep a rodeo from happening. If I can get him to go left or right in the back end, then I can prevent that buck when I feel him setting me up for it. Sometimes you can, if you've rode horses long enough, you can feel them when they getting that hump in their back. But anyway, guys, Graham got a lot of work, but watch his progress. I'm out.